folks. Clyde Lindsay here from Pixel Pro Displays. Thank you so much for taking the time to check out today's tips and tricks video. Now, before we get started, I want to thank you all for watching the videos that we put out in the past few days. And really quick, I want to remind you to please hit that like button down below if you like the video, and hit the subscribe button so you get notified from YouTube when we post something new and you're able to get that content right away. So today's little short video that I want to go through is some effect options when you're traveling or you're working within the X-Lite sequencing screen. So you can see here I have a bunch of morphs all stacked up together. And let's say I didn't start this morph exactly where I wanted it, where I want this block of morphs. So I want to move all of these effects. And what I can do is I can highlight them all in the timing grid, and then I can hold the shift key down and go to the very right. Doesn't matter which one, I can just go to the right, and as long as my mouse pointer turns into the double arrows left and right, I can click, left click, and I can slide and drag the entire selection either left and right, and it will stop whenever it comes into contact with something that obviously is on the same line right there. That little effect over there is causing me to stop. So with that in mind, there's some other functionalities on moving an effect that you might want to know about. If you have, let's say this morph effect right here. Let's say I want to extend the length of these morph effects. I want them to be longer. So what you can do is you can highlight all of them and move them. But I'm going to show you how you can highlight them and move them, and I just want to move like one little itty bitty edge. So you can do this. There's two ways to do this. I'm going to show you the cheat way that I do it. I move it slightly over, so this timing mark here is just over the edge of that morph effect. Now I'm going to select in these blocks these timing marks here that's going to highlight this half of the effect. And now I'm going to hold my shift key in and double arrows, and I'm going to drag it out. So now I can extend my morph effect the entire length, or I can extend my sets of effects for however long I want them to. So this is nice whenever you realize, oh, I really like this effect. I want it to draw out over a longer period of time. So there's one functionality. Now, the reason why this works is, here's the same effect, okay? If I have reached the exact center of the morph effect, if I've got half of any of the effects, as a matter of fact, whenever I select them all and I go to drag them, they if this side over here, if this timing mark is just as big as this one, if they're equal, that won't work. It will move the whole thing. Well, in this case now, these two happen to be this happens to be a smaller size and this is a bigger size. But in some cases, this area here, this cell here, might be the exact same size as this. And when that happens, then you have to slightly drag them over, just like I showed you. You have to do that, or here is the cheat. Let me just do a couple undos here. And we can do this other cheat. So if we unselect the timing marks, now we're kind of in a freeform click drag selection mode. And let's say I just wanted these two here. I can select only these two effects. And if I go over here, I should be able to click and drag them out. So now we have a little bit more functionality between, or freedom. We have a lot more freedom because we're not tied to the timing marks. Once again, if I want to just get the very edge and move this edge, I can do that. Okay. So just some little things there. Now, one other thing I want to share with you is what happens whenever you want this effect here that's landlocked between these effects, because you'd have to click all of these, you'd have to click them and drag them out, and then you'd have to make this one smaller and this one smaller, or as I'm teaching you now, you could do this. So okay, fine, now I made this smaller and I pushed this back in here, but now wait, where was it? Was it here or was it here? I don't know. So let's go back and let's just hit Control Z and we'll go back. And this is where our little finger pointer comes in handy. So if you want to separate two effects, all you have to do is move it right to the edge, not over top, not here, because now you've got the two connected together. You can change to the finger pointer there, drag that in, and you can make that the exact size that you need to make that, for whatever it is that you're trying to accomplish in your sequencing endeavors. So the other final little itty bitty secret that I'll show you, because it absolutely goes in step with the little finger pointer and the separator here, is what happens if you have some timing marks that you want to delete. Timing marks are a little bit different. They work like an effect, but they don't move. But they do move. So I'm going to show you this. So we can go up here, and you have to have a timing mark activated. So let's say I want to delete this timing mark. I just select it with the finger pointer, not the double arrow, but the finger pointer. And then I can click and I can drag, or I can delete. And the delete is the delete key on your keyboard. Now let's see if I come over here and I do the same thing, arrow point, I can pull and drag it, or I can just get down to that level and hit delete, and that deletes the effect, timing mark. So now we're actually free to move this timing mark around. And if you are into the singing faces, this is one of the beginning steps to being able to double click here, and you can edit a label track if you have that functionality. Sometimes you can just double click here. I'm set up to double click on a timing track and play that section. But I have to hold shift down to open up this label track. You may not have that functionality set up in your settings. That's down here. So double click somewhere down here. But that's far beyond what I wanted to get into today. But I wanted to share with you how easy it is to move effects around, how to make changes in X-Lights, and do some editing to your start and stop locations in the as far as the effects goes. And I know that maybe a lot of you don't have a whole lot of this, but remember a whole lot of effects layered. But remember, at the very least, sometimes you may have a group of effects up here that you want all of this to move all at one time. Well, if that's the case, you can deselect your timing marks. You can select whatever it is you need to select, and they could be over multiple props. They don't have to be all on one prop. So I thought this was a wonderful lesson for everybody. Folks, if you enjoy the video, once again, please hit that like and subscribe button. Hit the bell notification to let you know whenever we post something new. And by the way, we sell some amazing holiday sequences. If you haven't signed up for a free membership to the PPD website to get more content, we hold a ton of webinars throughout the year, and we look forward to getting some more ideas for other videos. You're welcome to send those in to us as well. If you have any comments or questions, put them in the comments down below. We do read those. So thank you so much for joining us today, folks. Have a wonderful day, and we'll see you in the next video.
Chimney with old Sam. Sam, and every time it rains, it rains.